If I can't picture it, I can't understand it. Albert Einstein. Welcome students. आज इस लेक्चर में हम थिन लेंसेस के कॉम्बिनेशन, थिन लेंस के साथ, प्लेन मिरर के साथ, स्फेरिकल मिरर के साथ एंड ग्लास स्लैब के साथ, या अभी तक जिस टाइप की हमने ऑप्टिकल डिवाइसेस पढ़ी हैं, उनका लेंसेस के साथ कॉम्बिनेशन से इमेज फॉर्मेशन कैसी होगी, इस बारे में डिस्कस करेंगे। ऐसी कुछ सिचुएशन में एक कंसेप्ट है, कंसेप्ट ऑफ पावर। वो कई बार बहुत यूजफुल होता है, लेकिन आपने देखा होगा कि जिस तरह से हमारी बुक्स में कंसेप्ट ऑफ पावर एज ए फार्मूला इंट्रोड्यूस कर दिया गया है, मैं एट प्रेजेंट एज ए फार्मूला किसी कंसेप्ट को यूज करना एडवाइजेबल नहीं समझता। सो इस लेक्चर में हम सारे कॉम्बिनेशंस को, जो बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स हम लोगों ने पढ़े हैं, केवल उन्हीं के हेल्प से सॉल्व करेंगे एंड यू विल सी दे आर मच सिंपलर सॉल्यूशन। इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द कंसेप्ट ऑफ पावर इन डिटेल एंड देन वी विल ट्राई टू यूटिलाइज द कंसेप्ट ऑफ पावर इन ऑल दीज सिचुएशंस एंड वी विल सी वेयर वी विल फाइंड द सिंपलिसिटी। एक्चुअली पावर के कंसेप्ट को, वो कंसेप्ट क्या है, कैसे ओरिजिनेट हुआ, अगर हम वो बात समझ लें तो उसको यूज करना आसान होगा। सिंपली रिमेंबरिंग ए फॉर्मूला एंड यूजिंग इट आई विल नॉट एडवाइस। सो टूडे विल डिस्कस ऑल दिस कॉम्बिनेशन विद द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड टिल सो फार। सो बिफोर वी प्रोसीड, लेट अस हैव ए क्विक रिविजन ऑन द इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर्मूलेज फॉर ऑल द डिवाइसेज एट ए ग्लैंस। Frequently used formulae. We'll consider spherical mirror, spherical interface, and lenses. And here, first we take equation. For a spherical mirror, the equation is 1 upon u plus 1 upon v is equal to 1 upon f. For a spherical interface, it is mu r upon v minus mu I upon u is equal to mu r minus mu I upon r. For lens, it becomes 1 upon v minus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f. And here for spherical interface, mu r stands for the refractive index of the medium in which rays after refraction travel. It means the medium in which refracted rays are present, and mu I is similarly the refractive index of the medium in which incident rays are present. Then focal length for a spherical mirror, for paraxial condition, that is r by 2. Of course, all these relations are holds true only for paraxial conditions. And we have seen earlier, discuss it. If it is not specified to consider marginal rays, we have to automatically consider the paraxial rays. For a spherical mirror, this is a focal length. And for lens, it is Lensmaker formula. 1 upon f is equal to mu l with respect to outer medium minus 1. 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. Here I am not discussing the focal length for spherical interface. It is, if it is asked to calculate the focal length, depending on which focal length, first principal focal length or second principal focal length, we can consider the object at a particular position. Say for second principal focal length, object is at infinity, where the image is made is called second focus. And for first focus, the object is at the first focus and image is considered to be at infinity. So accordingly, these two definitions will help us to calculate these focal lengths. Now we can consider the transverse magnification. Transverse magnification is usually is called height of image upon height of object, but not always it is height. Actually, it is extension of the image and object perpendicular to the optical axis or principal axis. So this extension perpendicular to the principal axis, we usually denote by height. So transverse magnification, M is equal to HI upon HO, that is minus V by U for spherical mirror. For spherical interface, again, M is equal to HI by HO, V minus R upon U minus R, or mu 1 V upon mu 2 V. Depending on situation, which information are available, we can use either this expression or that second one. For lens, the transverse magnification HI upon HO is equal to V by U. So please take care of sign here. For a spherical mirror, it is minus V by U. For lens, it is plus V by U. Again, we consider the axial magnification. In axial magnification, an object is placed along the principal axis. And for any size of object, this formula is very general. M is equal to VA minus VB upon UA minus UB. Similarly, for a spherical interface, VA minus VB upon UA minus UB. And for lens, M is equal to VA minus VB upon UA minus UB. Now, for infinitely small size object, another relation that can easily be deduced by differentiating these equations, the image formation equation, but here we have derived it earlier, so I am writing the formula here again. For infinitely small object, M axial is equal to dv upon du is minus v square by u square is minus m square for spherical mirror. For spherical interface, M is equal to again dv by du is mu 1 v square upon mu 2 u square or minus mu 2 by mu 1 into m square. And for lens, M axial is equal to dv upon du is equal to v square by u square or simply m square. So now these are the formula which we have to use frequently when we are studying combination of devices. Again, the basic principle behind the combination of devices, let us discuss. Optical events or devices in tandem. In tandem is one after other. मतलब एक के बाद एक अगर ऑप्टिकल इवेंट्स हो रही हैं या एक के बाद एक डिवाइसेस रखी हुई हैं तो जो जनरल प्रिंसिपल होगा फर्स्ट डिस्कस ऑप्टिकल इवेंट्स रिफ्रैक्शन और रिफ्लेक्शन इन टैंडम व्हाट इज जनरल प्रिंसिपल यू नो इट वेरी वेल इफ एन इमेज इज फॉर्म्ड आफ्टर सेवरल ऑप्टिकल इवेंट्स द इमेज मेड बाय एन ऑप्टिकल इवेंट सर्व्स एज एन ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर द नेक्स्ट ऑप्टिकल इवेंट अगेन How we decide the sequence of optical event is will be evident from the ray tracing. Try to trace the ray. Which event the ray will encounter first is comes first, and the ray encounter the event later is comes later. So here now this can be used for a device. Oh, it is maybe possible in some devices there will be several events, or sometimes we may have several devices one after other. So, optical devices, mirrors, slabs or lenses in tandem. Again, the principle is same here. What? If an image is formed after light passes through several optical devices, the image made by a device serves as an object for the next device. Again, sequence of devices will be evident from the ray tracing. So, in every problem, as we discussed earlier, if you try to draw the ray diagram, you'll find solution will become very intuitive. At the same time, the ray tracing will provide an extra check. It may stop you or it may prevent you so many times from committing mistakes. Now we are well prepared to consider few example problems. Say let us take the first example. Example 1. A thin convex lens of focal length 40 cm is placed 90 cm away from a plane mirror. A point source P is placed on the optical axis of the lens 60 cm away from it as shown in the figure. Find location of the final image. Now setup is given as shown here. What is that? Here is a convex lens. Focal length of the lens is given. And that is 40 cm. It is placed 90 cm away from a plane mirror. So here is the plane mirror. Now, a point object is placed 60 cm in front of the lens on the optical axis. Say here, the P is the point source. Now, we have to find the final image made by the lens. Now, just see the situation. Any ray which will go here past the lens and it will fall on the mirror. It will reflect it back again past the lens and make the final image. So here lens refracts the ray twice and mirror once. But what is sequence? First refraction from the lens, then from reflection from the mirror, and then again reflection from the lens. Now this idea will suggest us in what sequence we have to consider the devices. One thing, And here, the ray tracing will give you the procedure how we proceed. So let us say how we proceed with the solution. Image made by a device serves as an object for the next device. That is the basic principle. But how we can decide which device is first and which device is next? That idea will be given by the ray tracing. In addition to the above idea, the ray tracing suggests that rays after refraction from the lens will be reflected by the mirror and then again be refracted by the lens. So the desired sequence, it means first image will be made by lens, that image will serve as an object for the mirror, and second image will be made by the mirror, and that second image will serve as an object for the lens, and then lens will make the final image. Now, which kind of image will work, which kind of object, virtual or real, that will be more evident if we proceed with the ray tracing step by step calculation. First we find image position from the lens, then draw the ray diagram. It will help us to decide which kind of object is the second image, is first image is. So what we proceed, in first we'll logically think the ray diagram, how the ray will interact in what sequence with devices, and then after step by step calculation we proceed with the ray diagram step by step. So what we consider here, thus the first image made by the lens will serve as an object for the mirror, which will make the second image, that will serve as an object for the lens again to form the final image. Here, ray tracing in combination with step-by-step calculations will make the solution more intuitive. That was I am saying here. Don't try to draw the ray diagram at once in the beginning. Just we draw, calculate the image position for the lens, then we draw the ray diagram. And that ray diagram will suggest how this first image will serve as an object for the mirror. Then we calculate the image position from the mirror. Then we draw next step in the ray diagram. And again, after calculating the location of final image, we complete the ray diagram. First image Q made by the lens. Let us name the image. So we have given the name P for the object. Next image Q, next image R, next image S. In sequence, we'll give the name. So first image Q, and it is evident it is made by the lens. So here that we are trying to produce the ray diagram. So this will show us sign convention and object distance. What is sign convention? Rays will start from P and travel towards the right. So rightward is the positive sign. So U will be minus 60, and focal length is given, that is 40 centimeter. And for convex length, it is positive. Now we'll use the image equation 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. Substitute the values 1 upon V minus 1 upon minus 60 is equal to 1 upon 40. And after solving it, you'll get V is equal to 120 centimeter. It means the first image is made towards right at 120 centimeter away from the lens. Now we can complete this ray diagram. So this image, we have seen the two rays. We can show the third ray also passing through the pole, but no need. So this is what? A real image. So Q is a real image. This is a real image and serve as a virtual object for the plane mirror. How we can say virtual object? Because mirror is placed before the image. And this ray diagram suggests distance of the mirror was 90 centimeter from the lens. So here this mirror will block these rays. So we have shown these rays now by extended lines, and these rays will be reflected back by the mirror. So we'll see the image will be made here. This distance, you can see how much, 120 minus 90, 30. So again image will be made 30 centimeter in front of the plane mirror. So no need to proceed calculation with the plane mirror. Now this will work as a virtual object. So this ray will be reflected back. So here we'll find a real image in 30 centimeter in front of the mirror. This virtual object is 30 centimeter behind the mirror. This way, 30 centimeter. Second image are made by the mirror. Let us consider it again. So द रेज रिफ्लेक्टेड फ्रॉम द मिरर मेक ए रियल इमेज आर दिस वे एंड एज दिस डिस्टेंस इज 30 डिस्टेंस विल ऑल्सो बी 30 बिकॉज फ्रॉम ए प्लेन मिरर इमेज एंड ऑब्जेक्ट आर इक्विडिस्टेंट दिस रियल इमेज आर इज 30 सेंटीमीटर इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मिरर नाउ जस्ट सी दिस रे ट्रेसिंग विल सजेस्ट यू हाउ दिस सेकेंड इमेज विल सर्व एज एन ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर द लेंस नाउ इट इज अ रियल बिकॉज दिस रे विल प्रोसीड एंड एक्चुअली फॉल ऑन द लेंस सो आर विल वर्क एज ए रियल ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर द लेंस अगेन सो दैट इज 30 सेंटीमीटर वी शोन नाउ फ्रॉम हियर यू कैन इजिली कैलकुलेट वॉट इज डिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस आर फ्रॉम द लेंस दैट इज इट इज वॉट 90 माइनस 30 60 द इमेज आर सर्व एज ए रियल ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर द लेंस Rays forming the real image R will proceed towards the lens and will be refracted by the lens. Thus, the image R will serve as a real object for the lens. Actually, rays are coming here. Now, what we can see further calculations. So, we'll say here, these rays are again, these rays are proceeding towards the lens. And here after refraction for the lens, they will make another image. So it is clear from the ray diagram that R will work for the lens as a real object. Similarly, Q will work for the mirror as a virtual object. Now we can proceed further with the calculation. The image R serving as a real object for the lens is 60 centimeter away from the lens. You can easily calculate 60 centimeter because 90 minus 30 is 60. So this data will help us to substitute the values in the lens equation again. But and the ray diagram will suggest us to use sign convention without any mistake. So 60 we have shown here. Now let us see here final image as made by the lens. So we again redraw the ray diagram this way. That first image made by the lens, it will work as a virtual object for the mirror. Second image that is 30 centimeter here R, real image. So again, 30 centimeter in front of the mirror. Now this remaining distance is 60. So this will work as a real image, real object. So 60 centimeter. Now we can see from this ray diagram, the rays are propagating towards left. So sign convention here, leftward is positive. So sign convention towards left is positive. So U will be again here minus 60. So U will be minus 60. Focal length is 40 centimeter. Now we substitute the values. 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. So 1 upon V minus 1 upon minus 60 is equal to 1 upon 40. Again, V is equal to 120 centimeter. So this image will be formed 120 centimeter left of the lens. This is a real image. 120 centimeter left of the lens as shown in the extended ray diagram given. See here. So this ray diagram till so far we have produced earlier. Now we extend it. So this rays will go here and make image somewhat here. See this way. That is what this here. Yahan tak hum kar chuke the. Now just see. These rays will make an image here, final S, and that is 120 centimeter. Now by observing this diagram, we can predict answer. It may be possible that answers is distance of final image from the object. So you can see 60 centimeter towards left. Distance of final image from the mirror, you can see 90 plus 120, how much? 210 centimeter towards left. So whatever in the form answer is asked, you can predict clearly from the ray diagram. So ray diagram will again give you very intuitive understanding of situation. So what I suggest you, till you'll become very much expert, that ray diagram you can think in your mind. Keep on drawing the ray diagram again with the step-by-step calculation. And whenever there are several events or several devices, you cannot produce the ray diagram at once in all situations. So what is required, as we have done in this problem? See, perform calculation of the first interaction, then complete ray diagram, then go for the second interaction, perform calculation and complete ray diagram. So in combination of this problem, always try to proceed with step-by-step calculations and step-by-step advancement of the ray diagram. Now, we should take the next example. Example 2. Consider the given setup consisting of a real object P, a convex lens and a convex mirror. Find the location and nature of the final image. So that setup is given here. Here we have a converging lens or convex lens. Focal length of that is 20 centimeter. Here we have a convex mirror or diverging mirror. Focal length of that is 25 centimeter. Distance between the lens and the mirror is 50 centimeter. And distance between the object, real object, and the lens is 30 centimeter. So we can simply see ray will proceed towards right, will be refracted by the lens and make an image. And where this image, if this image will be here, we can say it will work as a real object for the mirror. If the image is made here, we'll see it will work as a virtual object. And where the image will be formed, it will decide the sign convention for the mirror. So let us first calculate image made by the lens, first image, and we'll again draw ray diagram step after step by step calculations. So let us again think the principle. Image made by a device serves as an object for the next device. Second, in addition to the above idea, the ray tracing suggests that rays after refraction from the lens will be reflected by the mirror and then again by the be refracted by the lens. So ray diagram, the mental imagination will decide the sequence of events in this way. First, it will be refracted by the lens, then it will be reflected by the mirror, then again the rays will be refracted by the lens. So what we can see, thus the first image made by the lens will serve as object for the mirror, which will make the second image that will serve as an object for the lens again for to form the final image. Now, in first, the sign convention is clear that u will be minus 30, but for mirror, u will be positive, negative. That will be more evident if you draw the ray diagram after calculating image distance from the lens. So what we do here? Here, ray tracing in combination with step-by-step calculations will make the solution more intuitive. And one more thing, as we have seen in the previous problem, the step-by-step making of the ray diagram will provide you an extra check, especially in sign convention. So here, first image, Q, made by the lens. Now, we will not show the mirror, only the lens. So we can see here sign convention, very easy. The ray will proceed towards right. So right, what is positive? So U will be minus 30. And F is given to be 20. So let's substitute the values. 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. So 1 upon V minus 1 upon minus 30 is equal to 1 upon 20. After solving, you'll get V is equal to 60 centimeter. So from the lens towards right, image will be made 60 centimeter. So it is evident it is a real image. This way, we can draw the ray diagram. So this is the ray and it will bend. And it here is the second focus of the lens. So it will pass the focus. So the focal length is 20. So we have shown the focal length 20 centimeter. Now we can take the second ray through the pole. It will go undeviated from the lens this way. And here these two rays are intersecting. So here is the image Q. And image distance is 60 centimeter. So this distance is 60 centimeter. Now, how this first image will work for as an object for the convex mirror? We'll place the convex mirror and it will be evident. We'll place here the convex mirror in the ray diagram. This is a real inverted and enlarged image. It serves as a virtual object for the concave mirror because the mirror is placed before the image is made. Actually, mirror is placed somewhat here. And distance of mirror was given to be 50 centimeter from the lens, so we have shown here. And focal length of mirror is 25 centimeter. Now you can see this mirror will stop the rays. So we have extended the rays by dashed line and we have shown this object. What it shows? If there were no mirror, this image would have been made. So this image will work as a virtual object for the mirror. Now, so this ray diagram will suggest us how this object is virtual. And this distance is evident of the Q from the mirror is what? 10 centimeter. And for a sign convention, they are pushing towards right. So for sign convention, this u will be plus 10. So here this ray diagram will help us to decide sign convention values for the successive events. Now one thing, here we have please shown the mirror by a particular symbol. This is the symbol of a concave mirror for paraxial condition. The virtual object is 10 centimeter behind the mirror. Say this, we can calculate 10 centimeter. So 60 minus 50 is 10. Here the concave mirror is shown by its symbol. Second image are made by the mirror. We'll see the second image. Now second image will be made by the mirror. Now you can see the sign convention. Rays are propagating towards side to right, what is positive. So u for the mirror is plus 10. And f is again plus 25 because for diverging mirror focal length is positive. Now we can use the mirror equation 1 upon v plus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f, and I substitute these values to find v. So 1 upon v plus 1 upon 10 is equal to 1 upon 25. Solving this, we get v is equal to minus 50 by 3 centimeter. This is a real image made 50 by 3 centimeter in front of the mirror. Now we can proceed further with the ray diagram. If we try to show this image here, this will be 50 by 3 centimeter. But here in this ray diagram, there are so many details. So let us try to redraw the ray diagram again to show only those details in which we are interested, or we can say we are trying to do it for better readability of the diagram. Second image are made by the mirror. So here this is a first ray, that is we are showing the image made by the lens, first image. So this is, and that was Q, and it was how much distance? 60 centimeter. We are not showing that. And now we have shown the mirror and how this first image will serve as a virtual object. So we have calculated that second image will be made 50 by 3 centimeter in front of the mirror. So I'm showing this image, say this R, and this will be what? 50 by 3. Now we can very easily say that this second image will work as an object for the lens, and this will be what? A real image, and ray will propagate towards left. So sign convention is evident again for the lens, left what is positive. So final image as made by the lens, what is sign convention? Left what is positive, you can see. So u will be what? 50 minus 50 by 3, that will be 100 by 3. How just see it this way, 100 by 3, because 50 minus 50 by 3 is 100 by 3. So this is what? Minus 100 by 3, because this direction we have taken positive, and this 100 by 3 will be measured from the pole of the lens, so it will be minus 100 by 3. And focal length is given again 20 centimeter. Now we substitute these values in lens equation. 1 upon v minus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f. So we can calculate here 1 upon v minus 3 upon minus 100. So this value is substituted, 1 upon 20. And solution of this will give us what? V is equal to 50 centimeter, means positive. So final image will be made left of the lens at what distance? 50 centimeter. This is a real image, 50 centimeter left of the lens, as shown in the adjacent extended ray diagram. Again, we can see here, this was, we again proceed here, this what? First image Q, we place the mirror. This is 10 centimeter distance of this image from the mirror, and it will make second image R, that is what? 50 by 3. Now at this point, we have shown these two rays, but they are infinite rays. So there may be some rays which may be coming parallel to it. So we consider that one this way, this ray. And this ray coming parallel to the principal axis will pass through the focus, and this distance is 20 centimeter. And a ray passing through the pore will go undeviated, so it will cut somewhat here. So this way. So here is what? The final image S. And you can see very clearly from the diagram that final image is what? Real. First thing, enlarge because P is smaller, and you can see, and erect, 50 centimeter, that distance. Now we have to see further what is asked: location and nature of the final image. For nature, we have to calculate magnification, and of course qualitatively we have seen that the final image is enlarged, erect and real. But for the magnification, how many times it's enlarged? We have to calculate magnification. For again, we are proceeding with the ray diagram. I'm drawing the ray diagram again and again just for you to become expert in ray diagram. So that was the first image. We can see we have placed the mirror. This distance is 10 centimeter because that was 60. So here that is second image, R, 50 by 3. So this will be what, 100 by 3. So this was ray diagram. It passes through focus. This is 20, and second ray through the pole will go undeviated this way. So here is what final image S. Now we calculate this 50 we have shown. Now we are ready to calculate final image S as a real, erect and enlarged image, 50 centimeter left of the lens. Now what is the overall magnification? Magnification means HS upon HP, overall magnification, HS upon HP. But this we can rewrite: HQ upon HP, HR upon HQ and HS upon HR. You can see again, this will cancel out, this will cancel out, we can see this one. But why we are rewritten this? Because if you see HQ upon HP from the diagram, Q is the image of the lens, by the lens. So it is first magnification by the lens. HR is the image by mirror, and HQ is the what, object for the mirror. So it is what, magnification by the mirror. So again, you can see here, HS is the image by lens and HR is the image for the object for the lens. So it is again magnification by the lens. So in what way the events have been occurred, or in what sequence the light has interacted with the devices, we have to multiply the magnification, and it is evident here very much from the ray diagram. So what we can put the values: first magnification from the lens, VQ by UP, and for the mirror, VR upon UQ with minus sign, and for the lens, VS by UR. So put the values. That was 60 upon, it was minus 30. So that was minus 50 by 3 upon 10. Then it is what, 50 upon what, this is minus 100 by 3. Now by solving this, you will get 5. It means the final image is enlarged 5 times as compared to the initial object. Now, these problems have given us enough idea how to use the principle. What image made by the first device or first event will act as the object for the next device or next event, one thing. But step-by-step calculation and ray diagram tracing will suggest you that the image which is working as object for the next device is a real object or virtual object. At the same time, the ray diagram will help you to decide the sign convention for the events to occur next to next. If you don't do the ray diagram, there is a great chance that you will commit mistakes in sign convention. So I will suggest you to draw the ray diagram with step-by-step calculations. Now we'll come on the next example. Example 3. A slab of thickness T is equal to 3 cm made by a glass of refractive index mu is equal to 1.5 is placed somewhere between a point source P and a converging lens of focal length F is equal to 20 cm as shown in the figure. Find location of the image made by the lens. Of course, the final image. See here. Here is the lens. The distance of lens from the object is 31 centimeter, and here is the glass slab of thickness T is equal to 3 centimeter is placed. Now, if you think before we proceed further with the how will be the ray diagram. Ray coming from here will be refracted once and again twice and then go on the lens. And this two times refraction of the glass slab, you can remember the glass slab will introduce a shift in the position of object, and that shift was given by simple formula t into 1 minus 1 upon mu, and the direction of shift is towards the advancement of the ray. So this glass slide will shift the image somewhat here by an amount calculated by this. But in what way the glass slide will shift? If you draw the ray diagram, it will be evident. So we follow the same procedure using the principle that the image made by first device will serve as object for the next device, and drawing the ray diagram after step-by-step calculations. So let us discuss the solution here. Image made by the glass slab serves as object for the lens. That was the idea. And ray tracing with step-by-step calculations will provide more intuitive understanding and reduce chances of error by providing extra check. Why I'm saying reduce the chances of error, especially in sign convention. Now see here, first image Q made by the glass slab. We know the glass slab will introduce a shift, and the formula for shift is, we can use here, the glass slab makes a virtual image shifted in the direction of ray advancement. The shift is S is equal to T 1 minus 1 upon mu. Let us substitute the values. 3 into 1 upon 1.5, it will be 1 centimeter. Now if you know the formula for shift and direction of shift in the advancement of ray, that is clear. So we can see the image Q will be somewhat here, 1 centimeter. But if you draw the ray diagram, the direction of shift will be evident. The image serves as a real object for the lens. This fact is more evident from the ray diagram. And we'll draw the ray diagram. For that, we again see here, the rays reaching the lens after refraction from the glass slab make the virtual image Q that serve as a real object for the lens. Here, only two rays are shown for better readability of the diagram. Say, we'll consider on the effect of glass slab. So this is P, say these two rays, and this ray will bend towards the normal, and then again from the normal, now after refraction these two rays will be parallel. So if we for lens will receive these two rays, and if you back extend these two rays, they will meet somewhat here. So here is the image Q, that is C. So this image Q is actually virtual image because no light rays are actually reaching it, but for the lens it will be a real object. So direction of shift is evident from here towards in the direction of ray propagation, and amount of shift was 1 centimeter. Second image R from the lens. For that we try to complete the ray diagram and see here. This is what after that these rays will reach the lens. So instead of showing so diverging rays, we have seen we are showing rays at some smaller angle. So they will reach the lens here. Now, if you back extend these rays, this is the image Q. So we have not shown P, only Q. That is what? The image made by the glass slab, which is working as a real object. So this distance actually from lens, it was 31 centimeter. So now from lens, the image, this distance of Q is what? U is equal to D minus S. D was 31, S is 1. So it is 30 centimeter. Now this diagram will suggest us to decide the what is value of u, one thing, and sine of u according to sine convention. And sine convention is what? Positive towards right, because the rays are advancing towards right. So u is equal to minus 30, and focal length of the lens was given 20 centimeter. Now we substitute these values in lens equation. 1 upon v minus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f. So 1 upon V minus 1 upon minus 30 is equal to 1 upon 20. So V is 60 centimeter, that you can verify. So after the lens, this way the image, a real image will be made 60 centimeter, because what it suggests, the image finally is made towards the right. So this again, the final image is made 60 centimeter right of the lens, and it is a real image. This is a real image made 60 centimeter to the right of the lens. Now let us come on the next example, that is example 4, and we have almost similar example, but in this example we place the glass slab after the lens. A glass slab of thickness t is equal to 3 cm and refractive index mu is equal to 1.5 is placed after a converging lens of focal length f equal to 20 cm as shown. Find the location of the final image of the point source P. So situation is somewhat same, but here glass slab we are placing after the lens and we have used the same data just to simplify calculation. Now again, the idea is what? The first image made by the lens will serve as an object for the glass slab. And step by step calculation of ray diagram will provide us better understanding, as well as in some calculations it will provide us extra check to reduce error. Image made by the lens is object for the glass slab, and ray tracing with step-by-step calculations will provide more intuitive understanding and reduce chances of error by providing extra check. So what we take first image Q from the lens. So we'll have this way. For lens, just see this ray coming from P will strike the lens. So this will decide the direction of ray advancement and hence sign convention. So sign convention towards right is positive. So from here it is clear that U is minus 30. Focal length is given 20 centimeter. Now we substitute these values in lens equation to find V. 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. So 1 upon V minus 1 upon minus 30 is equal to 1 upon 20. So solve this, you'll get V is equal to 60 centimeter. So lens will make here image 60 centimeter. This. Now, of course, from this device, this distance is apparently less than 30. So the glass slab will be before the Q is made. If distance of glass slab were more than 60, so there is no effect on the image formation by the lens. But glass slab will again make another image. But here, the glass slab is given. This diagram you can see, of course, this distance is not given, but it is evidently less than 30. So glass slab is placed before the image made. So this image will work as a virtual object for the glass slab. Final image R from the slab. The shift, you can calculate what is shift as earlier, t 1 minus 1 upon mu. So 3 into 1 minus 1.51 upon, so it is 1 centimeter. So the glass slab will shift the image further in the direction of ray advancement here. So the image R will be here at 1 centimeter. So final distance of the final image from lens will be 61 centimeter. And that is again clear by ray diagram. So this reflection will bend ray towards normal. Again, it will make parallel to the incident ray. So in this way, this ray will be shifted. So this is shift. So this ray diagram will provide you to estimate direction of shift also, if you forget the shift is in the direction of ray advancement. And so 1 centimeter. So that is total distance from lens is 61 centimeter. The final image is real and 61 centimeter to the right of the lens. Now, in the same sequence, let us consider next example. Example 5. A point source P placed 40 centimeter below the water level is viewed through a magnifying lens of focal length 300 centimeter. The lens is kept 20 centimeter above the water level such that the point source lies on the optical axis of the lens. Assuming the refractive index of water to be 4/3, calculate the location of the image of the point source as seen by the observer. Here in the diagram, situation is shown. So this eye is shown, it means the observer is here, it is looking. He is looking at this. So if you logically think ray diagram, ray will go here and bend away from the normal. So they will make somewhat a virtual image above P. And this virtual image, actually the ray are coming from lens, really ray. So this virtual image of P made by reflection from this water level will work as a real object. And lens will make another image of that. So this logical thinking will give us a crude idea of sequence of events. Now we'll proceed further with the solution. The virtual image made by refraction at the water-air interface serves as a real object for the lens. First image Q made by the water-air interface. Let us calculate. So here you can use the idea of apparent depth, but what we have seen earlier, instead of remembering idea of apparent depth separately, consider a refracting plane refracting surface as a spherical refracting surface of radius of curvature infinite. So use the same relation. So what is here, again we are redrawing. So distance of P from the interface is 40. So ray are coming on this direction, so U will be upward positive. So the sign convention upward positive, but just see, as we have think earlier, these two rays go here and they will bend away from the normal, again bend away from the normal. So if you back extend them, so they will make a virtual image of P here, say Q. Now what is sign convention? Upward is positive. So from here U is minus 40. And radius curvature is infinite because a plane surface. So you will use the relation plane surface reflection. So mu r upon v minus mu I upon u is equal to mu r minus mu I upon r. So let us substitute values. Mu r is 1 upon v. Mu I is 4 by 3 upon u, that is minus 40, is equal to 1 minus 4 by 3 upon infinity. So it will become 0. By solving this, you will get v is equal to minus 30 centimeter. So again, this first image is made minus 30 means below the water level 30 centimeters. So this will be, again, this you have calculated by idea of apparent depth. What is apparent depth? Actual depth upon refract index. So 40 upon 40 by 3. So this is 30 centimeter. So you could have done this, but what I have seen, if you have a general relation, it is better to use that general relation. So in so many situations, it will help you to avoid some confusion, because we are using similar relation for all kinds of refracting surfaces. So this 30 centimeter, we can show this distance 30 centimeter. Now we can see from here, this virtual image is working as a real object for the lens, and the distance of this object is what? 30 plus 20, 50 centimeter. This is a virtual image, 30 centimeter below the water surface, or 50 centimeter from the lens. Now to consider refraction from the lens, we'll use the lens equation. Again, this ray diagram suggests us for the lens, the upward direction is positive, so U will be minus 50. Final image R made by the lens. The image Q made by the refraction at the water-air interface serves as a real object for the lens that we have seen previously. So that was just, we are not showing P, only the Q. So that distance was 50. And this ray diagram will make us evident that this will work as a real object for the lens. So sign convention upward positive. So U will be minus 50. And focal length is given how much? 300 centimeter. F is equal to 300 centimeter. We substitute these values in lens equation. 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. So 1 upon V minus 1 upon minus 50 is equal to 1 upon 300. By solving this, we'll get V is equal to minus 60 centimeter. It means where the image is met, this lens will further converge. So these rays will not intersect after lens. So their back extension will intersect somewhat here below the Q. So here this at R, the final image is met at R. This minus 60 shows. Again, what? Image will be of the same side as the object is. So that distance will be 60 centimeter below the lens. There is no further refraction at the water-air interface as back extension of the light rays, nor the actual light rays, are crossing the water-air interface. That is very, very important point. Now here, actually refraction or reflection will take place only with the real rays. there is no refraction or reflection for the geometrical extension of the rays. So if you back extend, there is no refraction at all. So this is the final image. Thus, the image R is the final image. It is a virtual image and located 60 centimeter below the lens. So that was idea. Now you can see how the ray tracing will provide you better understanding. And after solving large number of problems, there will be no need to draw the ray diagrams all the times. But if you are expert in drawing ray diagram, wherever you will find any confusion, you can draw the ray diagram for extra check. And if you become comfortable in solving the problem without ray diagram, I would recommend you to proceed with the calculations. Now let us consider the next example. Example 6. Find the nature and position of the final image. Focal length of both the lenses is 20 centimeter. So this is situation. Now here we have two lenses. One lens is a convex lens, other one is concave lens. Means first one is converging lens and second one diverging lens. Distance between the lenses is 20 centimeter. And this extended real object is placed 60 centimeter before the convex lens. And focal length of both the lenses is 20 centimeter. Now we can think, rays will go and first interact with the lens, convex lens. So image made by the convex lens will serve as object for the concave lens. So that was sequence. So here what? Image made by the convex lens serves as object for the concave lens. At the same time, ray tracing with step-by-step calculations will provide more intuitive understanding and reduce chances of error by providing some extra check, especially in sign convention. So I'm writing these two things over and over again in every example. It means they are very important. If you understand these two ideas, their philosophy behind these problems, if you follow these two things, of course you can solve any problem with utmost ease. So we'll first calculate first image Q made by the convex lens. So here again I'm considering the ray diagram. So we are not considering here this diverging lens. So this rays from P will go towards right. So sign convention is positive towards right. So U will be minus 60. Sign convention, positive towards right. So U will be minus 60 centimeter. And the focal length is given 20 centimeter. Now we can calculate 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. So 1 upon V minus 1 upon minus 60 is equal to 1 upon 20. Solution of this will give you V is equal to 30 centimeter. How the images are made, we can see from this ray diagram. So that is what first ray coming parallel to principal axis will pass through the focus. Here is a focus, 20 centimeter. And a ray passing through the pole will go undeviated. So we can see here, we get an inverted and somewhat smaller image, Q. But this lens was placed at 20 centimeter. So this lens converts, this diverging lens or concave lens is placed before this image Q is made. So this Q will work as a virtual object for the second lens. This is a real inverted and smaller image. First thing, it is evident from ray diagram, no need to calculate, it is smaller and enlarged. It serves as a virtual object for the concave lens. It is evident from here, we are placing the lens. So now this lens will bend the ray somewhere else. So I am showing here by extended rays dash dash dash. So this was Q. If this lens were not there, this image would have been made. So this image will work as a virtual object for the lens. Now this lens will make its own effect and make another image. So let us consider that one. Final image are made by the concave lens. So we have redrawn the ray diagram till so far we have done here. So this distance now we can calculate. This was 30 centimeter. And this lens was placed 20 centimeter away, so this is 10 centimeter. Now rays are advancing towards right, so sign convention is positive towards right, and U will be plus 10. Sign convention positive towards right, U will be plus 10, and focal length is minus 20 centimeter for concave lens. Now we substitute these values in Lenz equation. 1 upon v minus 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f. So what we get here? 1 upon v minus 1 upon 10 is equal to 1 upon minus 20. And by solving it, v is equal to 20 centimeter. It means the final image will be met 20 centimeter right of the diverging lens or concave lens. So this way, because this ray will go undivided because it passes through the pole. And this ray will be further diverge. So they will not cut here, it will cut here. So it is evident that the final image will be made further towards right of Q. And this calculation will provide us the distance 20 centimeter. Again, we can see final image is inverted, real, and somewhat larger than the first image. But we cannot see whether the R will be larger than P or smaller than P without performing overall magnification calculations. So here, this image is 20 centimeter to the right of the concave lens. Now, overall magnification. Because overall magnification will provide how much larger and smaller R is as compared to P. So M is equal to HR upon HP. So we can write here HQ upon HP into HR upon HQ. Simple mathematical manipulation. So it is what? M1, it is M2. That is magnification by the first lens. It is magnification by second lens. So M is equal to V1 by U1 into V2 by U2. So that is for first and second. And now we know the value. What? 30 upon minus 60 and 20 upon 10. We can see from here. V1 means this distance 30. And U1 is minus 60. So this. What is V2? This 20. And what is V1? Plus 10. So this. So again it is minus. So we get minus 1. Means the final image is of the same size as the initial object. One thing. Minus sign shows it is inverted. As well as real image. So the final image is inverted, real, and of the same size as the object P. Now, after learning these things, we can come on the next example. Example 7. Two lenses of focal lengths FA and FB are placed a distance d apart. For what distance between them does a parallel beam incident on the first lens emerges as a parallel beam from the second one? Now it is not given that which lens is diverging and which lens is converging. So we have to consider all the cases. What the cases are? A. Both are converging. B. Both are concave. C. First is convex and second is concave. First is concave and the second is convex. Of course, here convex means converging lens and concave means diverging lens because they are used in air. So how we proceed with the solution? The idea is, according to the given condition, it is necessary that if the second lens receives a converging beam, it must be a diverging lens. And if the second lens receives a diverging beam, it must be a converging lens. So what is, if the first lens is what you can say, the rays which are passing from the first lens become converging, so second lens must be a diverging lens. But here is a twist. If the first lens is convex lens, it makes a parallel beam converging, all the rays will converge at the focus and thereafter they will become diverging. So here we can see, again, if you place a first convex lens and second concave lens, it is also possible. And two convex lenses is also possible. So first we discuss the case of two lenses, both are convex. Here, method of ray tracing suggests a very intuitive, thus easy solution. Again, we can proceed with calculations as well as ray tracing. But we can see, here we always try to find way of solution by ray tracing. But here if you try to draw the ray diagram, you will find solution in the ray diagram as well. So there is no need of further mathematical step-by-step calculations. First, we consider both the lenses are convex. So what is that? द सेकेंड लेंस मे रिसीव ए कन्वर्जिंग और डाइवर्जिंग बीम डिपेंडिंग ऑन वेयर इट इज प्लेस्ड, दस इट मस्ट बी सो प्लेस दैट इट्स फर्स्ट फोकस कॉन्साइड्स विद द सेकेंड फोकस ऑफ द फर्स्ट लेंस. एंड दिस स्टेटमेंट विल प्रोवाइड सम बेटर इमेजिनेशन विद द रे डायग्राम. लेट अस सी हाउ दिस कंडीशन इज फुलफिल्ड विद द रे डायग्राम. See here, the first lens is converging lens. It makes this parallel beam to converge at its focus. And here, this second lens receives a diverging beam and makes it parallel. So this distance will be the focal length of the second lens, and this distance must be focal length of the first lens. So this is FA, this is FB. So distance is clearly D is equal to FA plus FB. Now in this condition, what we have taken? FA will be greater than FB. If FA will be greater than FB, then the final emergent beam will be narrower. That is evident from the ray diagram. Now, second case, we take FA is equal to FB. So here, if FA will be FB, you can see the second outgoing beam will be as wide as the first incoming beam. But D will be again FA plus FB. Here FA we have taken equal to FB, and outgoing beam of the same width as the incoming beam. Now if you take the second condition, FA is smaller than FB. In this way we can see the outgoing beam will be wider than the incoming beam, and again what D will be FA plus FB. So D is equal to FA plus FB, and we have taken FA to be smaller than FB, so outgoing beam is wider than the incoming beam. So that was the three possibilities with the two convex lens to fulfill the condition given that incoming beam and outgoing beam both must be a parallel beam. So now we consider the second case, both the lenses are concave. So what it will be? Both the lenses are concave. So we can see that from first lens, we receive what kind of beam? A diverging beam. And if you introduce further a concave lens, it will further diverge the ray. So there is no chance that we will receive a what? You can say parallel beam, because second lens must be converging. So it given condition, second lens should must be a diverging. So it is in this case, there is no possibility to make the beam again parallel. The second lens always receives a diverging beam. So by another diverging lens, it is impossible to further converge the beam and make it parallel. So to fulfill the given condition by two concave lenses, it is impossible. Now we come on the case C. First lens is convex and second is concave. So we can proceed with the ray diagram, but before we, let us think. The second lens is diverging. So it must receive a converging beam. Thus must be placed that its first focus coincides with the second focus of the first lens. Let us see how this. Now the second lens must diverge. So the second lens must be placed before this focus this way. Now this lens will stop these rays and it will make them diverge, so they will it is so placed it makes it parallel beam. So how we can see? For the first lens, this point is the second focus, and for the second lens, this line, this point is the first focus. So what is that? The first focus of the second lens must coincide with the second focus of the first lens. That's how this condition is fulfilled. Now we can see D is clearly FA minus FB. And here FA must be greater than FB, and outgoing beam is narrower. First is concave and second is convex lens. So what the first is concave, so it will provide a diverging beam to the second lens. So second lens may be converging. Now what is that? The second lens is a converging one, so it must receive a diverging beam. Thus must be so placed that its first focus coincides with the second focus of the first lens. The second statement is somewhat twisted, but it demands some imagination with the ray diagram. So let us see here. First lens, it makes diverging beam. And now we place is now if we extend back here, it is what the focus. And of course, this is second focus of the first lens. And this way, this is second focus of the first lens. Now if we place a converging lens, so it will make parallel. So this will be the first focus of the second lens. This way. So the, you can understand this idea. Now clearly here, this distance from here to here is what FB, and this is what FA. So D is what FB minus FA. And clearly here, FB must be greater than FA. Now, the outgoing beam is clearly wider than the incoming beam. So that was what here is the importance of ray diagram also. In some situation, you can find solution even with the ray diagram and much more easily. That's why try to practice the ray diagram in every problem so that you will be very expert in ray diagram. Again, we have seen in last problems that ray diagram provides us the way of solution. Actually, ray diagram plays the same role as free body diagram plays in Newton's laws of motion. Because without thinking FBD, you cannot make Newton's law equation. Similarly, without thinking ray diagram, it is in some situation become impossible to decide sign convention and put the values. And again, in almost in all situation, ray diagram provides you a very easy way of solution. Now let us come on the next example. Example 8. Radii of curvature of a thin lens made of a glass of refractive index mu are R1 and R2. The surface of radius R2 is silvered as shown in the figure. That was the situation. Here we have taken a thin lens. Of course, thickness is shown, but we neglect the thickness T as compared to R1 and R2 wherever it is required. Again, second surface is silvered, so it makes reflecting. What is asked? Where on the optical axis should a point source be placed so that the final image coincides with the source itself? It means where on the optical axis of this composite device, I will say composite device means it is combination of a lens and a mirror in a single device. So we have to place a point object on the optical axis so that the final image is will made on the source itself. What the idea is? Very simple idea that if the image is again made at the source, then all the rays outgoing from the source after first reflection on the surface and second reflection on the surface and then again reflection on the surface should fall on the source. It means very easy way is what the use of principle of optical reversibility. If any incoming ray on the device will retrace itself only when this condition is fulfilled. And for retracing on optical reversibility, here at the second surface, there must be a normal incidence only when optical reversibility is possible. So what we can think, the given condition is fulfilled if a parallel, if a paraxial ray after reflection from the silvered surface retraces itself, thus the ray must be at normal incidence at the silvered surface. That is how you can see how beautiful application of optical reversibility. In the beginning, I have shown you, I was told you that there are some problems which can be solved by concept of power. Actually, this kind of situation has been solved in so many books with the concept of power. But merely remembering the power as a formula, I'm not confident enough to use it. But again, instead of using that power concept, by using very basic principle, this idea, optical reversibility, you can solve this problem much more easily as compared to use of power. Again, consider the idea. What the thing is, we have to place a source at a, such a position that its image is made at a source. It means all the rays coming out from the source must, after reflection from here, retrace its path. So there, at reflecting surface, there must be normal incidence. So we fulfill this condition. And ray diagram will provide us the further way of solution. Just see, this ray, reflection back, and here is normal incidence. If normal incidence means, if you extend this ray will cut or meet here, what the center curve, which is C2 of the second surface. It means what we can think, that the image of this point source after first reflection must be made at the center of curvature of the second surface. This idea is sufficient to make the solution complete. So what is that? Here R1, R2, and this. Thus, the image made by the first reflection coincides the center of curvature C2 of the second surface. This is the key point of the solution. Now, image made by the first reflection. Sign convention, you can see, right what is positive. So this I will shown T, and this is what distance U and R2. So sign convention towards right is positive. So what we have, V is equal to R2 plus T with the limit T tends to 0. So V will be R2, and of course with positive sign. And R is equal to R. R is means radius curvature of the first surface, and it is R1. So with positive sign. And U will be equal to, we say, some REM. So VR upon V minus UI upon U is equal to mu R minus mu I upon R. That is what equation for the reflection at curved surface. So we'll substitute the values. Mu upon R2 minus 1 upon U is equal to mu minus 1 upon R. So what is mu R? Is the medium of the refraction index of that medium in which ray after refraction will travel. So this. So it is mu. And what is mu I? In which ray before refraction travel, incident ray. So this is 1. So mu R is mu and mu I is 1. And V is what? We have R2. So it's R2. Let us see U as it is. So mu minus 1 upon R1. Put the values for R is R1. Now we can calculate. 1 upon U is equal to minus mu minus 1 upon R1 minus mu by R2. So this what? U have it calculated. And that is what? Position of the source. Here if you place the source, the image of the source will be made at the source itself. Location of the point source can be obtained by above equation. So that was the idea. Now, why we have taken this first part is evident in by the second part B. What is the physical interpretation of the answer obtained in the previous part? That is very important idea. What do we mean? If an object and its image by a spherical mirror coincide, the object must be at the center of curvature of the mirror. That is very well known fact. If object is placed at the center of curvature of a spherical mirror, the image will be made at itself. And that was the idea. Actually, the composite device, the silver lens, will reflect the light back, and it may refract the light back as a diverging beam or converging beam or parallel beam. So it may behave as a plane mirror, it may behave as a convex mirror, or it may behave as a concave mirror. So here the importance of the first part is what? We want to replace the discomposite device by a spherical mirror. And by the first part, we are finding the center of curvature of the equivalent spherical mirror by which we are replacing the device. So let us further think. The above analogy suggests that the composite device, that is the silver lens, can be replaced by an equivalent spherical mirror, radius of curvature of which is given by the object distance calculated in the previous part. That was so simple. Now, again, let us see here. We place an object here. If the image is made at the object itself, so this object distance we call radius or curvature of the equivalent mirror. So here, for that, if it is center of curvature of equivalent mirror, the image should be made at the source itself. So here should be normal incidence. So image made by the first reflection must be at the center of curvature of the second surface, C2. And we have done its calculation earlier. So this U, and U will be what? Radius of curvature of equivalent mirror. And this is T, R2, and t is much much less than r1 and r2 because we are assuming thin lens. So this we are replacing by a equivalent mirror. Of course, here we are taking a concave mirror, for example, but it may be convex, it may be plane, depending on the REM. This U is REM. If REM is negative, it is concave mirror. If REM is positive, it will be a convex mirror. If REM will be infinity, it will be a plane mirror. So according to equation, 1 upon V U is equal to minus mu minus 1 upon R1 minus mu by R2. So instead of U, what will take? REM, without using sign convention, because it may be plus or minus. So 1 upon REM will be minus mu minus 1 upon R minus mu upon R to this. So this equation, if given a negative value of REM, so it will this device will work as a concave mirror. It will give a positive value of REM, so this device will work as a convex mirror. If this will give infinite REM, it will work as a plane mirror. Again, after calculating the radius curvature of the equivalent mirror, we can calculate the focal length. That will be REM by 2. Now, from silver device, we can solve any problem. And now you can see how easily we have done it without using concept of power. So what will be focal length of this equivalent mirror? REM by 2. So that was the basic principle shown in this example, by which we can tackle the situation of silvered lenses. Now let us implement this idea in some problems with numerical data. What example 9, radius of curvature of curved surface of a plano convex lens is 12 cm and refractive index of the glass is 1.5. Its plane surface is silvered. Part A, at what distance from the lens a parallel beam of light incident on the lens will converge? It means we are making an incident beam parallel on this composite device. So it will be reflected and it will converge at a point. So we want to calculate basically the focal length of the equivalent mirror. Just see, if the device is replaced by mirror, so it will focus the parallel incident beam at the focus. So what we have to calculate? Focal length of the equivalent mirror. So here, the composite device will behave like a spherical mirror. We don't know if it is convex or concave. And it is asked to calculate its focal length. If we will calculate REM, and half of the REM will be focal length. If focal length will be positive, it will be a convex mirror. If focal length will be negative, the equivalent mirror will be a concave mirror. Let us do the same thing. What we do? We'll make place an object at such a place so that rays after refraction from the first surface will be at normal incidence of the second surface. In this way, ray will retrace and make image at the object itself. So it will be, object is placed basically center of curvature of the equivalent mirror. That idea we use. Assume a point source at such a location as rays emanated from the source have normal incidence at the silvered surface after refraction from the first surface. Thus, all the rays will retrace their paths to cast an image at the source itself. Thus, location of the source is the center of curvature of the equivalent mirror. So how we can see in the ray diagram, just see here, we place a point source here. So U will be REM. Now, this we substitute without sign convention. So let it will be positive or negative, whatever it comes. So we assume ray here, and here it should be a normal incident. It means after the refraction at the first surface, image must be made at infinity. So we have to consider only one event, refraction at the first surface. So now, what will be sign convention here? Write what was positive. So U will be, we place REM without sign. So we want that REM must be with its sign. But V will be infinity. And what will be R? R1 will be plus R. And R1 will be plus R, or R will be this. So what is the equation? Mu r upon v minus mu y upon u is equal to mu r minus mu y upon r. So instead of V, we put infinity. Instead of R, we place plus R1. And instead of U, we'll place REM, radius of curvature of the equivalent mirror. So 1 upon infinity minus 1 upon REM is equal to mu minus 1 upon R. So what is REM? Minus R upon mu minus 1. Now you can see. We can remember the final expression as obtained in the previous problem and use the expression in problems to come. But remembering a formula, there is a great chance that we forget it. But this idea is so beautiful. Principle of optical reversibility, so you'll never forget. So try to understand this idea. I'm again repeating the idea. To find the center of curvature of the equivalent mirror, assume a point source on the optical axis. And the distance will be radius of curvature of the equivalent mirror. For that, after refraction from the first surface, the ray must be at normal incidence on the second surface. So, in this way, we calculate REM. Now, substitute the given values. Let us calculate REM, whether it is positive or negative. So, here, REM is equal to 12 upon 1.5 minus 1. So it is coming minus 24 centimeter. So the equivalent mirror is a concave mirror with the radius of curvature 24 centimeter and focal length 12 centimeter. So focal length of the equivalent mirror, what FEM is equal to REM by 2. So that is FEM is equal to minus 12 centimeter. It means what is asked? At what distance from the lens a parallel beam of light incident on the lens will converge? So, if a parallel beam of light is made to incidence on this composite device, it will converge at a distance 12 centimeter in front of this device. So, the equivalent mirror is a concave mirror of focal length minus 12 centimeter. Now, we can come on the next part B. If a real object extended perpendicular to the optical axis of the silvered lens is placed 20 centimeter away and in front of the silvered lens, where will its image be formed? Also find nature and magnification of the image. Now what the idea is, we in the first part we have calculated the focal length of equivalent mirror, so we'll replace the device by the equivalent concave mirror. By replacing the silvered lens with the equivalent concave mirror of focal length 12 centimeter, the situation at hand can easily be solved. So what sign convention will be? Because rays are propagating towards right, so right what is positive. So the object is placed 20 centimeter away, so U will be minus 20. And focal length is what? Minus 12. Again, it is focal length of the equivalent mirror. Now we can use the mirror equation. 1 upon V plus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon FEM. And V we had to calculate. So 1 upon V plus 1 upon minus 20 is equal to 1 upon minus 12. So solution of this will give us V is equal to minus 30. It means image is made further towards left at 30 centimeter in front of the device. Real image is formed 30 centimeter in front of the mirror. Why it is real? Because the rays are reflected and the image is made actually by intersection of the rays. So magnification, let us calculate. M is equal to minus V by U for the mirror. So V is equal to what? Minus 30. U is what? Minus 20. So M is minus 30 upon minus 20. It is minus 1.5. It means the final image must be real. Minus sign shows it must be inverted, and 1.5 shows means 1.5 times of the object. Thus, the image is 1.5 times larger than the object, inverted and real. Now, it is better to again practice the same idea in one more example. Now, we take a biconvex lens. What is example 10? One surface of a biconvex lens of focal length 20 centimeter is silvered. Refractive index of the material of the lens is 1.5. A point light source is placed 10 cm in front of the lens. Determine position and nature of the image. Now, idea is clear. It is silver lens. So we replace it by what? An equivalent spherical mirror. To find equivalent spherical mirror, what we use? We first find center of curvature of the equivalent mirror, or REM. Radius of curvature of equivalent mirror. What is the idea for that? For a spherical mirror, if image is made at the object, it means object must be placed at the center of curvature. So in front of this composite lens or composite device or silver lens, we place a point object, and a ray coming from the point source after refraction from the first surface must be at the normal incidence on the second surface. So it will retrace itself and make the image at the source itself. So location of source is what? Distance of center of curvature of equivalent mirror. So the idea is very simple. We'll try to proceed. The silvered lens will behave like a spherical mirror. If a point source is placed at such a location as rays emanated from it have normal incidence at the silvered surface after refraction from the first surface, the rays will retrace their paths to cast an image at the source itself. Thus, location of the source is the center of curvature of the equivalent mirror. Now, this is the idea. Suppose we place an object here, this U. U will be equal to REM. And for this, we will not use sign convention. Let us come REM as it is. If it will be positive, so equivalent mirror will be convex mirror. If it will be negative, the equivalent mirror will be concave mirror. So ray coming here, and after that this. So here we assume a normal incidence this way. It means if we extend it back, here should be what? Center of curvature of second device C2. This way. So that is R. Now what is given? It is biconvex lens. So both the surfaces must have equal radii of curvature. So before proceeding further, we have to calculate the value of R. For that, we can use lens maker formula. Again, we have to neglect value of T as compared to both the R's. Lens maker's formula, it will help us to calculate value of R because focal length is given 20 centimeters. So what is lens maker's formula? 1 upon F is equal to mu minus 1, 1 upon R1 minus 1 upon R2. For biconvex lens, mu is given 1.5, R1 is plus R, and R2 is minus R. So 1 upon 20 focal length, 1.5 minus 1, 1 upon R minus 1 upon minus R. And this will give R is equal to 20 centimeter. For radius curvature, both the surface are 20 centimeter. Now this is 20. So what we can see, image distance from this is what? Minus 20. Refraction at the first surface, sign convention towards right positive. So U is equal to limit REM plus T. So it is REM. And we will calculate from the ray diagram. And this ray diagram, again, we are drawing to consider refraction at the first surface. R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R20 centimeter that we have calculated. And just see here, this ray diagram. Here should be normal incidence. So this extension will cut at C2. So this is R, and T we have to neglect because T is much, much less than R. So what we can see, sign convention towards right is positive. So V is equal to minus R. Why minus R? Because this distance is minus R. So minus. So V substitute for V, minus 20. And further, we have to consider the plane spherical surface reflection. Mu R upon V minus mu I upon U is equal to mu R minus mu I upon R. So R is for first surface, is plus R, minus plus 20. We have calculated minus 20, and U will be REM. We will substitute U without sign. So let it be, come with its sign. So 1 upon minus R, minus 1 upon REM, mu minus 1, 1 upon R. So what we have? 1 upon REM is equal to minus mu by R plus mu minus 1 upon R. Now let us substitute the values. So 1 upon REM is equal to 1.5 upon 20 plus 1.5 minus 20, and after solving this we get REM is equal to minus 10 centimeter. इट मीन्स दिस कंपोजिट डिवाइस कैन बी रिप्लेस्ड बाई ए कॉनकेव मिरर ऑफ रेडियस कर्वेचर 10 सेंटीमीटर एंड फोकल लेंथ 5 सेंटीमीटर. Thus, the silvered lens will behave as a concave mirror of radius of curvature 10 cm and focal length 5 cm. But what is given? The point source as given in the question is placed 10 cm away, that is at the center of curvature of the equivalent mirror. So, its image will be at the source itself. Therefore, its image will be formed at the source itself. Again, this image will be a real image. And if it were an extended object, what we can say, the image would have been inverted and of the same size. Now, in all these examples, what we have seen that by using basic formulas and methods, we can solve all kinds of combination type problems. And basically, these combination types of problems are most likely to come in examination. Again, as I told you earlier, that in some problems, when the devices are placed in contact one after other without any gap, the concept of power can be used. But why a concept of power can be used and what is concept of power? Without writing you the formula in the next lecture, we'll devote in the concept of power. Actually, the concept of power comes from another method in geometrical optics that is called method of vergence or sometimes method of convergence. It is again another method. In this method, you will get rid of using the equation 1 upon V, 1 upon U and 1 upon F for mirror and for lens. Again, method of convergence is another philosophy. We try to discuss that method of convergence as well as method of power in the next lecture. So, today we'll conclude here and let us come on the home assignment. So, home assignment. Revise all the ideas covered today in this lecture and practice all the examples. I'm stressing again, practice all the examples over and over till you understand them very well. And thereafter, do the homework from SCV. That is exercise from SCV chapter 18. First attempt worked out example from 19 to 28 because till 1 to 18 I have given you earlier. If you are not done, again attempt all the work example from 1 to 28. And then till question 59 we have done earlier. Now attempt question number 60 to 79. That is of course for geometrical optics we have completed. Only one thing is remaining, concept of power, that we'll take in detail. For now, thanks for the patient listening. We'll meet in the next class. I am never content until I have conceived a model of what I am studying. If I succeed in making one, I understand. Otherwise, I do not. Sir Lord Kelvin.